All right, Ian here for Bass Squad. We're back after forever. About to go on a good trip up to North Georgia. Got all my stuff packed up in the car, and I'm gonna head up to North Georgia, and we're just gonna have to see what we can do here. We touched down safe and sound. We are in Cedartown, Georgia, and we're scoping out what we're going to be getting ourselves into tomorrow. The lake was looking pretty good. I didn't even think to bring the camera over there, but we have our fair time to shoot on it tomorrow. But the word on the street is they've been pulling a bunch of bass out of there, especially in recent past, that's upwards of 10 pounds. So we're hoping that we're going to be able to get our hands on something worth catching, something we're talking about. So Bass Squad. Alright, Bass Squad camera here. Didn't introduce him last night because we were dealing with some serious low light conditions. Mm-hmm. This is our host here, Winston Gim. Winston, what time is it?
It's about 4:15 right now. So.
Yeah. And what are we about to go do?
We're about to catch some fish.
Bass Squad, we'll get back to you guys with some more bass.
All right, Bass Squad video. We're on the water. Winston just lost one. We're getting over to our spot.
About 30 pounder.
It was pretty big. It was a big one. Using a lure, I don't even know what it's called, like the whopper plopper or something. It's kind of like a buzz bait, but it's an absolutely enormous lure.
Big lure, big fish.
Yeah, that's the idea. Absolutely beautiful area we're fishing this morning. A lot of rumors about big fish coming out of here. Well, not rumors. I saw the picture. A couple 8-pounders, 7-pounders, 9-pounder pulled out of here in recent past. So we're hoping to get our hands on something. Something with some size. So we'll get back to you guys with some more bass. Bass Squad.
Alright. Bass Squad, first one. Probably 2-pounder. Nothing too special. Probably the craziest hooking I've ever had though in my life. The hook went down in between the rear treble hook went down, the center of the hook went in between his gills, and the individual trebles had come up around different gills, or it's not his gill plates, I don't know, they came up around the different individual gills. So it took me a while to get it out, but I didn't want to just rip it out and kill him, but we got it out. Probably a nice 2-pounder starting the morning, so we'll get back to you guys with some more bass.
Minnow, we've got a minnow here for my next bait, so we're gonna fish with this here in a second, so stay tuned.
How much that one? Four and a half?
At least 8.
Bass Squad.
Bass Squad. We'll get back to you with some more bass. Got it pretty good. Same pound and a half. Pretty one. It's cute. Set there. Not terrible, but off to a good day start, so put it back in before she gets hurt.
Ooh.
Got another one. Not a bad day so far. And it's only early. So we're doing good so far.
They're laying into him back there with the wacky rig.
Yeah. So trying to.
Looking for one of those big ones.
Pumpkin seed color worm right here.
Just sweet tater pie.
Just fill them. That's all you got to do.
All right.
So put it back in.
We'll get back to you guys with more bass.
I switched to the hula popper, we moved spots, I threw it out there, and I was like, where's my lure? I literally didn't even pop it once. It got off because we were trying to get the camera, but I didn't even have to pop it one time. I had something hit the hula popper, so, well, yeah.
Bass Squad video. Winston just hooked into a good one. It's coming, here it comes. Ooh. What species is that? Oak?
I think this is a really rare. It's called a barkfish. Right, named by the sound it makes. It says bark bark.
You hold that one up there.
It's pretty. It's a good fish. They're native to all lakes everywhere. So, you know, it's got some age on it. It's a mature one, but I'm gonna put it back for the. I want to keep it. I don't want to let it die. So. Yeah.
Get back to you guys with some more bass.
Alright, another bass. Winston, I hung up on a tree and I was pulling a scent over and I was like, Winston, dude, don't make any noise. Don't use the trolling motor. I'm just going to pull this over there. And then Winston hung up and I was like, dude, hang on. And then I just flipped my jig 5 feet up underneath the dock. Nice 2-pounder, 1/2-ounce Strike King football head jig. I don't even know what color it is. I lost my black and blue one. I got a Reaction Innovations Sweet Beaver on the back as a trailer. And it's doing good. Nice fish, bass one, and we'll get back to you guys with some more bass.
Look at all those dogs.
All right, so we're headed on our way back out to the lake. This morning we did pretty good. We tore up a pretty good number. Wasn't really catching any of the big fish that we were looking for. The big fish that are in here. So we're gonna go back out this evening and see if we can get our hands on one 5 pounds or bigger. I think we got a little bit of a better idea of what we're gonna be doing after this morning. It was real slow, frustrating, but we ended up catching a pretty good bit and just nothing of any size. So again, we're just gonna go out there looking for those bigger bass. You got anything to say, Winnie? Riding in the absolute whip.
We're about to smack 6-pounder. Feeling it. Feel it in the air.
Just one 6-pounder?
Like Phil Collins said. No. Like at least 8.
Alright, so we're gonna catch 48 pounds of bass and 8 bass. No big deal. We'll keep you guys posted, basketball video, and we'll get back to you guys with some more bass. Alright, so first fish of the evening on the Zoom horny toad, the top water. About 1.5 pounds, 2-pounder, just another nice, healthy, meaty fish. So, still looking for that 6-pounder. We got about 8 more 6-pounders to catch before we get off the water tonight. So, we'll get back to you guys with some more bass.
Another nice one, Winston. I don't know what looks better, that fish or you in that Hawaiian shirt.
It's a close contest, I think. Let our viewers vote. Just email carter.van.dingler@live.mercer.edu with who you think. That's our secretary. So, and we'll tally him up and let you know next video who's cuter. You got Jonathan here or the Hawaiian shirt. So,
Bass Squad.
Bass Squad.
We'll get back to you guys
with some more bass.
That's the biggest one. That's the biggest one we caught all day. That's 2.5-pounder.
With the mouth of a fool. Look at that mouth.
Big.
So, we just got about a 5-pounder. 4.5, 5. Maybe 8. He's sitting right back there in that corner. Hit him with the wacky rig. Couldn't resist with my magic touch that I have. Just that right there.
So, wow.
Gonna put him back. Give him a little kiss. And set him free. Be free.
Why is he not? He doesn't really need to be.
There he goes.
Oh. They're so spent, like your dad says, I guess. Dude, Winston is going to work back there. Another fat fish.
When they hit, and so far they're treating me right. So this is not a 2-pounder, but not a bad fish at all. Happy to catch these all the time.
Bass one. Beautiful evening out. Oh, that's your signature, dude. And we'll get back to you with some more bass.
All right, bass one. Got a nice 3-pounder about on the buzz bait. Nice fish. Bass one. Hopefully a few more bigger than these. We'll get back to you guys with some more bass.
Best squad.
He just splashed the shit out.
So, good day today. Can't complain. Caught some nice fish, just not the ones we're looking for. Beautiful sunset, beautiful sky. Hopefully we'll get up in the morning and catch a couple tens. Till then, we'll see.
We'll get back to you guys with some more
bass squad.
Alright, we were out till dark last night. Can't even see Winston's about 5 o'clock. We are headed back to the lake for one final go. This morning is really gonna be the morning we get the big one. I know we've been saying it since we've been here, but we've just been joking around pretty much. We haven't really been trying too hard. We've just been kind of, you know, we've been letting the fish know that we're there. We haven't really been going at them, like, you know. But this morning we're gonna give it all we got. We're gonna throw nothing but big baits, and you know, fish all morning, and hopefully. I mean, even if we get one, I think we'll be content because it's going to be the 50-pound bass that we've been searching for. Do you have any words?
Dude, just hopefully we'll get back to you with some more bass.
And there you have it, Bass Squad.
We are down at the marina, and we just got into the boat, loaded it up. And,
We're
not gonna catch anything but absolute slobs this morning. Let me tell you, folks, it's gonna be great. We have the best fishing that any fisherman has ever had in the history of fishing. It's gonna be huge. Winston, the fact that we're gonna catch multitudes of huge fish this morning is not fake news.
No. It's going to be the greatest fishing to have ever been done in these great states. Listen, we are the silent minority because we fish and we don't brag too much. So, we're going to get back to you with the greatest bass. The greatest. It's going to be great.
Beautiful morning for the last morning. So, I got pretty sunrise coming up in here at the shallow part of the lake, top water fishing. So hopefully we'll get back to you with some.
We got a little helpful pro tip for you guys. Never fishing slow like it is for us right now. You got to do the fish dance. Here's one of the ones we use frequently. Oh, good traditional urban style of dancing there. Like the whip and nay-nay. But it is, I don't know what that one's called, but it was a good one. Alright, so the second one, we didn't film the first one, it was too little. I filmed a video of it, we took it out of the lake. It's too small. Here comes Winston on the lipless crankbait. They're pinning stuff up against this marsh and they're eating it, so we decided to throw something lipless at it. Practicing effective conservation techniques. He's
cute.
He's gonna take a nap now.
Go sleep, baby. You'll be okay. Good boy. So I'll lay you down.
Alright, so Winston here with another one. Almost immediately after the first one. Biggest one of the morning, pound and a half, I'd say.
Yeah.
So,
Winston.
Good job, Winston. Hopefully it's a good sign that maybe we're gonna start catching a bit more. Alright, so we're done for the weekend, and about to head on home. Winston, it's a pretty good weekend. You know, we didn't catch the one we wanted, but we caught some good ones, caught a lot, so.
Yeah,
we got our hands on quite a few, but the monsters out here are still out here, and hopefully we'll be back another day to get that 18, 20 pounder. Maybe that 28 pounder we saw this morning we can get our hands on.
Yeah, it hit top water, but. Hit a buzz bait, but it was just slapping at it, so.
Yeah. All right, well, as always, Bass Squad. And what are we going to get back to them with, Winston?
We're going to get back to them with some more bass.
Well, the big one we're looking for, but he's still tearing into him pretty good.
This is a good 18 inches or so.
How big do you think it actually is? 8 inches, 9 inches?
Yeah, it's about the size of a good pecker.
Bass Squad video. Bass Squad.
All right, Bass Squad here. All right, Bass Squad camera here.
All right, Bass Squad video. Bass Squad.
Bass Squad first.
Bass Squad.
Bass Squad video.
Nice fish, Bass Squad.
Bass Squad. We'll get.
Oh, Bass Squad.
Oh, Bass Squad backflip.
Bass Squad. And we'll get back to you with some more bass.
All right, Bass Squad. Got it.
Bass Squad.
He just splashed.
Bass Squad.
There you have it. Bass Squad.
Bass Squad. Bass Squad.
Bass Squad.
Bass Squad.
As always, Bass Squad. And what are we going to get back to them with, Winston?
We're going to get back to them with some more bass.